Hey my friends, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to paint this hazy landscape scene. So we start here with the pre-mixing process, the colors on the left side, you can see here. And we basically use these two lighter colors for the sky and the other four for the landscape itself. I came into using these kind of canvas blocks here that I'm using here now. I really like them because we have the color basically really getting into all those little holes that we have here. Anyway, back now to the painting. We apply the lighter color on the left side and transition to the bit more blue color on the left side, on the right side. By just blending them here and there to get a really nice kind of transition between those colors. And then we start with the underpainting of the landscape. And the key here is that you really try to get in this blurriness that we want to have here on the edges of those different parts that we have here. And we start with the lightest blue tone in the back, and then we grab the next darker blue tone for the next layer of landscape. And I already try to get in some of those details here, some kind of tree details, very rough ones as you can see, but basically already starting to add those fine little details. Then I mix a little bit of lemon yellow into this blue and try to build up again some more details, some kind of meadows here and there, some tree forest details coming up now. As we step to the front, we need to include the color itself from those vegetation that we have here basically. And again we get darker next layer, and when we finish this one we start to paint the layer in the front. And can we add already those fine details here and there, kind of resemble those mountain, those forest parts. Then I decided to go back and do some more blending here and there on the edges, just to get in a bit more blurriness, a bit more depth, a bit more unsharpness to the whole painting. It really helps to communicate the distance even better, and again, I add some more details to the mid-level. Then I let the whole thing dry for a couple of days and mixed set of flash colors for the cloud area here. And you see it looks out now here, this kind of brownish color that we have here. But we soon start to apply this kind of grayish bluish color, the lighter one first, then a darker one, and then I start to blend again and try really to build up this haziness, this washing out of the cloud here on the edges. I'm using very thin amount of color on the edge, as you can see here. Color itself is not only lighter, but also a bit thinner. And the same goes for the next cloud details that we put in here now. You see again, I'm using very little color on the brush, kind of a glaze, more or less. And then start to add all those highlights on the clouds, those areas where the light hits in from above, more or less. And it's basically a game of staying patient and random in shape, size and color to really get in a cloud that looks realistic. Don't repeat yourself too often. Yeah, and then we build up the detail parts on the mountains. And this is done very easy by just adding in a bit darker color. Also some color variations here and there, getting a bit browner. A bit more green here from the meadows that we have here. And yeah, just kind of glaze them, glazing, dry brushing them over the already dry underpainting. And with this you basically can build up mountain details in a couple of minutes. It's really very simple. Yeah, here I'm adding some more lightness to the front part to get in a bit more of this haziness, a bit more of this character of the mountain basically melting into the background. And this principle of just adding some more color here and there, doing some color variations, getting a bit greener, getting a bit browner here and there, it's basically all that you need to build up kind of a mountain scene here that starts to look realistic and starts to have even more kind of layers of depth that you basically want to have put in to make it look realistic. I also note that I'm getting darker, especially now on the street details here. Again, having this bluish base color theme, but already adding a bit more yellow to it to include even a bit more of this forest character, of this wood character here. Yeah, and you see me here adding now, going back to the level behind and adding some more to enhance a little bit more this piece here. Done very easy, again mixing a lighter color and kind of dry brush blending it in, and this really helps to save a ton of time and build up this detail part here even faster. Here now we are working on the layer that comes next to the foreground layer, and again I'm getting a bit more darker and also I'm adding a bit more of this lemon yellow to this mixture here to get in a bit more green tones here and there. And again, it's just kind of hinting those details here by again reusing the underpainting that I did before, and just adding some more layers, some more extensions here and there that kind of resemble the forest. And then we finally start to build up the front layer by using a brush. And you see I'm using the brush flat and a bit turned so that we have this brush applying the color kind of shaped like a blade, so I'm doing here now, turning the brush so that we have the blade side up to the canvas. And with this you can really easy basically get in some single trees very quick. I mean, they are not fully fleshed out, of course, but painted in and added in a bit to make the viewer's eye kind of stop when he is watching over this part here. Yeah, then I add some lighter greens here and there. It's kind of a in between tone here. Just to break up the whole thing a bit more in detail. And the same goes for the left part. Again, I'm toying around, getting lighter, darker here and there. Adding some more details. Again, using a very fine brush, kind of a blade, you see here. And it's really, yeah, it's a very quick way of building up details on such a small and yeah, kind of a landscape study. I will do this painting perhaps on a larger scale, but just to, yeah, to hint those details here and there, to get in those lighter and darker areas. And this, yeah, really helps. Kind of a trick, kind of a easy way to build up basically those details that you want and need. And here again, readjusting the background. Make some more and darker details, some more layers of depth in the back, more or less here. A bit more of a far more distant mountain here. Not quite enough. Grab some more color. Very thin layer and basically dry brush it on to get another layer of mountain here in these areas. Yep, then we're finished. So that's it again for today. If you have any questions, just let me know. And before you leave, please make sure you check out one of these other two videos here.